Hello. He's a candy.
What? Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another segment of the Bickering Game.
We're recording.
Hello, America. Triple M reporting in here.
Shell Dragon Knight here.
And yeah, Rosemary's here too.
Yeah, Rosemary. We have a special guest here, Rosemary.
Well, so, not a special guest.
I've been here. Yes, dear. We know.
Well, anyway, a long time ago.
No, they saw the bit. I'm sure. Well, it's pretty obvious. It's pretty fucking obvious. I had to. I'm sorry.
Wait, we're doing a Star Wars recording?
Yes.
Oh.
I had to make this really.
I'm sure I thought it was Mario.
It's extremely obvious what we're doing.
Foreshadowing.
So yeah, I think we push in your face. I think we. We pushed in your faces enough what this is about today. Today we're talking about LucasArts. Now, it was last month, well, a little more than last month, when they closed their doors, and they've been around since the 80s. The idea was George Lucas wanted video games. You know, the guy makes all the money on the merchandise, so.
He
opened up LucasArts, and they've been in charge of Star Wars video games. And you know what? Star Wars was such a big franchise, they had the right to have a whole company dedicated to their games alone.
Damn straight.
And they make games.
But also, in the end, they also made some non-Star Wars titles, but none of them really come to mind. If anyone wants to speak up on any, they can.
Wait, for LucasArts?
Yeah, LucasArts.
Actually, LucasArts did a...
The viewers need to hear him, so.
I don't think they do.
Well, actually, I think LucasArts did non-Star Wars topics, I think, like, it was for the N64. I saw it, and I was like, holy shit, LucaSarts did this.
Yeah.
It was a,
be surprised.
I think it was a racing game, and it wasn't the Star Wars racing game.
Yeah.
It was an actual like car race.
Yeah, you'd be surprised what they've done. They've done some side projects. They were
good games. Yeah, they were
very legitimate. They were just as legitimate as Capcom and who else?
Yeah,
so Sega. But Sega made hardware at the time when they opened. Like, it's hard to say. Like, there wasn't at the time LucasArts opened. There wasn't really many third party companies. A lot of people made hardware back then. So it's tough to say. Oh yeah, Konami. Yeah, what am I saying?
Yeah.
There's a lot. JMC. Who actually? There's a lot. So LucasArts is just on the table, but they made a big. They made a difference. You know, the Star Wars is a franchise that really makes a lot of people's lives. You know, it's like some people get really obsessed with it. And the games are no different. Although a lot of Star Wars games have a tradition of being very, very difficult. I'm playing Super Star Wars in this first recording. Man, that is a hard...
Yeah, I know.
Anyone who watches AVGN knows how fucking balls hard this game is.
Yeah, I didn't like
balls
Super Star...
Balls
don't get hard. Sweetie. You, the things you don't know. Anyway.
Really?
Anyway, but
seriously?
Actually, I will say this, though.
Stop being excited about that.
This is actually one of the many Star Wars games I hated. Like, I remember there was one time, it was for the Xbox, it was called The Sith Lords.
Oh, I remember that one.
Do you
remember
that one?
Yeah.
You actually had to put the little test shooter ball that Luke Skywalker faced in the first movie to learn about the Force. You put it on top of your TV and you have the lightsaber. That game sucked. Balls.
The Kinect Star Wars sucked at balls too.
Yeah, I know.
You can suck balls.
Balls really bad.
Anyone who watches JonTron, you gotta watch the episode.
Watch the video, you'll know.
Oh, he made a great. His review on that game was perfect. It was so funny too. it's like, what am I doing? No.
Back down the menu. Back down the menu. Come on.
There's dancing. Is Han Solo doing the mashed potatoes?
Yeah.
Oh, classic.
I know, right?
They made it too easy to use the lightsaber.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, you know what? No, I hate the ones like... Here's the thing. I hate games, especially the Star Wars games, where you have to be... where you have to use the lightsaber because you have to stay within the capture range... It sucks. I'm sorry. It frustrated the hell out of me, especially Sith Lords. You know.
Well, there's a lot.
Come on, come on. You go. Can I get a hooyah?
No, I agree with you.
Can I get a hooyah?
Yeah. Yeah,
thank you.
Hooyah.
Oh my goodness.
Thank you.
He's a Canadian.
But you know what? You find that you play a lot of. You find that, you know, you dig through a lot of game collections you might have, and you will always find at least one LucasArts game.
Yep.
They made a lot of people's childhoods. There's this one, their N64 game titles I think are the best. They made some really cool games in the N64. And such.
Yeah.
But when I heard LucasArts, was closing, I was shocked. Like, I never thought they were going anywhere, especially since they're the ones who make the Star Wars games, of all things. I don't know what the decision was. Was it because Disney's doing the new Star Wars movie? Was it because, I mean, was it, Jimmy? Do you know?
I'm not too sure, because I didn't get too much information, but my hunch is probably something to do with Disney making that new Star Wars movie.
Yeah, I'm not going to assume that. I mean, why would Disney, like people hate that idea, but I'm like, what's the big deal? Disney doesn't bother Marvel when they make their movies, and they're not going to bother the writers for Star Wars when they make their movies. It's like, I don't really see what the big deal is.
Well, Disney never really made movies for Marvel, did they?
Disney owns Marvel now. It's like, why is it such a bad thing? They're not stupid. They don't bother the people. They just let them do their job. They know what they're doing.
When did Disney own Marvel?
Since 2000. I think 2009.
Is that why the Marvel movies have been better?
I don't know. It's debatable. Maybe. But yeah, Disney knows what they're doing. I didn't know what the big deal was. But I can't say for sure. But that's where I'm getting at. They're good at business. They're good businessmen. I mean, that's why they're still here and they never go away ever. It's like, why would they get rid of LucasArts? That's why I'm not thinking that's why. They probably had money problems or something. Because I haven't heard about a good LucasArts game in a while.
Is it LucasArts?
You know? So who knows?
Yeah.
What do you have to say about this mad military man?
Well, if mad military man has anything to say about this...
Yeah, I was waiting for one of those.
I did it again. After all this time, I finally introduced you like this. Now, if Triple M has anything to say about it, I think that the Star Wars franchise for video games, it's very delicate.
Yeah.
Okay? It's very delicate. It didn't have a lot of good ones, and it didn't have a lot of... It had a few bad ones, didn't have a lot of good ones either, you know.
Well, the thing about...
But I liked a lot of them, like the Star Wars racer game. I liked... There was another one I liked. But so I'll admit, I did like Super Star Wars, but you know.
Oh, Super Star Wars is fun, despite the fact that it's really difficult. It's one of those games that you really want to beat. It's just so fun.
Yeah, I guess.
Like it's Ninja Gaiden type hard. It's just satisfying the difficulty, and you want to get through it. Like I game over on the first level, but I played it again. I ended up beating it. But the second level, I gamed over again. I didn't bother doing the whole thing. We'd be here for hours if
Sounds
I did.
Sounds like all my first games.
Yes, dear.
You're funny.
But yeah, Star Wars games were notorious for being very difficult, in at least the earlier ones. By the time the N64 came, that's when they got their formula set. That's when things were getting good. That's what they like. They were always pretty good. There were some really bad ones, of course. But I'll just say it again. Watch the AVGN episode on Star Wars. You'll know exactly what I'm talking about. Like he said it better than anyone I can think of. Other than the one on the he's never gonna do the Kinect game. But yeah, watch the Chantron one too. I'll give you suggestions today, viewers, because I'm nice. But
money has to be.
Yeah. YouTube contractually obligates all people to be nice.
Yes, be nice.
No, that's not true.
No.
If it was true, YouTube would be a much better place.
Or worse.
Yeah, and they did some interesting things. They made the pod racing games and whatnot that were really fun. They made I think they made party games. They had a lot of variety, LucasArts. They were just a good company. They knew what they were doing. That's pretty much it.
Yeah, pretty much.
So we're done?
No, we're not
no,
done.
No, we're not done.
No, we're not done yet.
Yeah.
No.
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 No. No.
Creeper.
Yeah. So,
So, Shadow Draco, what do you have to say about this?
Yeah.
He has to say,
The only games that I actually played were the Pod Racing one for 64, and then there's the, Star Wars X-Wing Alliance, if any of you had it. It was for the PC, and I
found that game to be very interesting, that it took the... Actually, it took out most of the scenes you see in the movie where you see the fighters clashing for dominance in space. It put you in the cockpit of all those fighters you play as. But the only problem is you can play as cruisers. But what I do know is... it is a shame that LucasArts is closing because they had a lot of potential from all the games they created. And you know, I hate to see EA be the next one in charge of the Star Wars series because yeah. they are money grubbers.
I know.
Money grubbers and you're bastards.
Yeah, I know. It's total. I think that's a total injustice. How dare they?
How dare they? They're like.
You know what, EA probably asked, I can bet you $1 million that EA asked for it, and they pretty much pushed them to make them do it, and then they, because they know that Star yeah. Wars games will sell by the millions, and, oh.
You know, I have to say,
I don't like
it. Do you mind if I, like, say, like, something about the EA thing taking over, do you mind if I say something?
Yeah, sure, that's good enough.
You know,
away.
I'm sorry, this seriously scuffs my boots.
You said it.
Yeah, I said it.
And then people like said in the video, oh, okay, he said it.
No, this really seriously scuffs my boots, alright? EA... come on. When you think of EA, what do you think of? Sports games. I don't care what anyone says. You think of sports games. Okay? I have a boxing game made by EA.
Which is the only reason why they're still in the business.
I know.
They're such children. Like the crap they're doing Nintendo right now. Because they offered Nintendo, and by that they pushed Nintendo to make them use their internet provider for the Wii U. But they said no because they know it's a piece of shit.
Yeah.
And then EA had a little childish bitch storm about it the whole time. And canceled game after game for the Wii U after they said when it was released that it was a great console. No, a few months later, they say it's crap and it's not worth making for. And then a week later, they say they're working on a new game for the Wii U.
Maybe they're pregnant.
Yeah, really.
They're being vigilant children that have their pockets filled with money, and they want more money to fill their black holes for stomachs.
Yeah, I know. It's like if George... It's just an injustice. That's all I can say.
It's just injustice to George Lucas and Lucas...
LucasArts made a lot of kids' childhoods, and they really did. They really, and because of course it's because Lucas was involved, and they really gave to Star Wars. Well, not all the time, but most of the time they gave it justice, and sometimes they actually expanded it. There was a few N64 games where they made totally different stories that collided with the movies. Like one of the N64 games were a story between Episode 4 and Episode 5 with this one guy in the Rebellion breaking away from the whole Rebellion and fighting alone. It was really cool. It was a great idea. I remember that game very well. It was very fun. And EA, I don't know what they're going to do.
You know what? Listen, I told you. This does scuff my boots, but you know what? I said it with the PS4. I said it with the Xbox One. Let's see where it goes. All right.
Well, no one's saying that.
No, I'm saying let's see where it goes. I mean, personally, really? I think this time I actually think that they're probably going to fuck something up. But you know what?
I'll be honest. They probably won't.
It won't last very long.
It's just they'll do it for the money.
That's what I mean by freaking
up. And the games
up.
Will be freaking bland.
Yeah, that's what I mean by fucking up.
That's the problem. It won't end. You can't, like Star Wars, you can't get rid of Star Wars games. They're not going to go away.
But you... That's what I mean by fucking up. I mean, they'll keep on going, but they'll still fuck up.
Somebody else will come along.
They should have gave that to Ubisoft. They should have gave the Star Wars games to Ubisoft. They would have done a great job.
I mean, listen, I know you're gonna have things that fail and they're gonna keep going. Have you ever heard of the French Army? Come on.
But yeah.
Hey,
what?
There's a French
Army. Remember what I said about the game for PC called the X-Wing Alliance?
Yeah.
It was actually a separate story from the main Star Wars series that LucasArts did.
Yeah, you know what? It's creative. It's taking. They were that kind of company to take their own artistic license to take the Star Wars universe and expand it or make it their own.
And that story was basically it was a separate like trading company at Neutral Ground that basically after incident going with the Rebel Alliance, I believe. Star Wars fans, please don't freaking blame me if I say this wrong. After something like a trading deal with the rebels gone wrong, the Empire labeled the neutral party as traitors, and they had to run and join the alliance. And then that's where your character comes in, from a a training guy or part of a training group to start joining the Rebel Alliance fleet.
Yeah, I know. Well, the LucasArts did that, and the one thing, I have no idea where Star Wars games are gonna go. I don't know where Star Wars is gonna go for that matter. They're not. This is
going to EA games. We established.
It's in the game.
It's like EA. Like Star Wars Episode 7. We're not sure of the actual George Lucas Episode 7, because George Lucas in his childhood, he written these stories, and he actually written up to Episode 9, but the final trilogy he said he'll save, and then we don't know if this is the actual one or not. I don't think so. I think Disney made this one, but it's a question of what they're going to do. Are they going to make literal movie translations, or are they going to, I don't know.
I think they should stay away from literal movie translations.
Yeah, you have to treat those very carefully.
Because you know what? Sometimes, literal movie translations of games have been known to put things in it, you know? Like,
yeah, like...
did you know that Shrek 2 had, had Rumpelstiltskin in it? I think it had the Pied Piper in it, and the Pied Piper didn't come until the last Shrek movie.
Yeah,
put the Pied Piper in Shrek 2.
Yeah, it gets confusing, complicated. But the thing is, what they have to be careful is Star Wars fans are very Star Wars has a great fan base. It's just you have to be careful with them because
they're delicate.
Yeah, because if you treat Star even George Lucas himself got shit. The creator of Star Wars got shit for screwing up Star Wars and all the DVD remasters and Episode 1-3. I mean, really, I'm a big Star Wars fan myself, and I will tell you, I only believe there are 3 Star Wars movies. I do not,
which is Episode 4, 5, and 6.
Yeah, I do not. I just want to like Hulk, like the first Hulk movie from 2006. I want to ignore. Oh, 2003. Yeah, 2003. I want to block Episode 1, 2, and 3 from my mind, except for the very last scene. The very last scene, Episode 3, the only good part of the whole thing is when that one part where Darth Vader goes no. That's the only good thing.
And Spider-Man.
Nice.
Yeah, Steve.
Spider-Man was awesome.
Not the last three, well, the last 4 movies. Well, you know, the first 3.
Yeah.
No, the first 3 was awesome. Series. The first 3 was awesome.
It depends on how you see it. Oh, look, a video game.
Oh, yeah, oh, look, a video game, yeah.
You know, we should play that game. I never played it before.
You played it. You played The Last Race.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
You never played it either.
I'm on the bottom screen.
You're on the bottom. Who's on top?
Greg's on the top screen. He's player 1, and I was player 2. I said top screen. So that applies.
You said you were on the bottom.
I was on the bottom screen. Yeah, pod racing was the... Oh, everyone had pod racing for the N64. That was such a cool
one. Yeah, and the only one to have weapons was the... What's the guy's name again?
What? Oh, it's just Star Wars. Yeah, it's just Star Wars Episode 1 Podracer. I think they made a sequel to it that was a little more combat based, but yeah, everyone had the first one, and everyone loved this game.
The first one, the only Podracer that had legal weapons on it was the Fallen Forge one that had the V-shaped air intakes.
I think so.
Yeah, it was the only one that was the flame for then that every time I do 2-player split screen, I always use that one and I end up crashing around the track.
Right, yeah. Well, we were talking about LucasArts, right?
Yeah, we're talking about LucasArts, yeah.
I'm being sarcastic. LucasArts...
Yeah, I was talking about
What's that?
Actually, that is a legitimate question. What is LucasArts?
We said that already.
He wants to talk.
Oh, yeah. You can go ahead. Go ahead.
Hello, America. Triple M reporting. Oh, wait. I did that already. Yes. Oh, excuse me. I did that already. We did it already.
Yeah, so stop being rude about
Shut
it.
Shut up. My ear. I mean, I need it
you
for
want me
ear.
So, anyway. LucasArts is a lot like Rare to me. They had a prime that was so powerful that every kid knew it was a household name, and that weren't the big three, and I'm referring to And I'm referring to Nintendo, Sony, and... Well, it'd be Microsoft today, but it was Sega back then. And the whole idea is just, like, they had a prime, but slowly they started to drop off, and... I mean, it's not completely... I'll be honest, it's not completely 100% impossible to understand why they closed their doors, but... At the same time, it's just, you can't imagine, like, I just simply can't imagine a world without LucasArts, because they were the only company to have a Star Wars game. Like, once in a while, they'll get people to help them, and I might be wrong, there might be a couple Star Wars games, at least unlicensed ones or knockoffs by other people, but George Lucas was always very, before they put a computer in front of the man, he was always very careful with his stories, and he wanted his creations done the way he wanted them done. So he had his own game company do it for him. And, you know what, it worked out very just fine, but, you know what, these things happen.
Which is,
yeah.
Well, you know, if I could just say this, I said this before, maybe they won't screw up, maybe.
It's not,
there's always a chance.
Well, it's not the question they'll screw up. It's just the fact that it's just a plain injustice that these people, that, you know what,
it took out the reins.
Yeah, like honestly, they'll probably do a great job.
Yeah,
it's
but just, you know
it's,
what?
It's them, that's the problem.
I know, they'll screw up because there's blandness, there's probably going to be blandness.
They're not going to care,
if they're doing their job, why do you care who...
Fuck
they are
anyway. No, it's like, it's not the fact, they'll do their job.
They're not charged for that DLC or something.
Yeah, it's like, they'll do the job, but they'll do the bare minimum, and they'll expect the most money out of it. They'll do the least amount of work possible,
yep.
And ask for the most amount of money possible. That's the problem. Like, Jimmy was just telling you a story about DLC, why don't you tell it?
I know most of you have seen me do videos for DLC Most Wanted. As you know, it's by EA and Criterion Games. Currently, I have the Need for Speed Most Wanted DLC for Ultimate Speedpack, but not free DLC released like about a couple months ago, I believe. And you can get it on at GameStop $24.99, but the problem is it's an expansion pack for the Most Wanted series that extends the game a bit, and EA expects you to pay up $24.99 just for three pieces of a DLC, not a whole game. I could get a brand new game for that, and I thought, what the hell is wrong with them? It's not fair towards the players, but if you want to get all free, you can get this. You can get it, but you gotta cough up the money.
Yeah. I'll say, I keep thinking that they should have gave the rights to Ubisoft.
Yeah.
Not only are they a very fair third-party company, who do a good job with and take a lot of care and passion what they do, but they are very fair people. They're very fair people, especially with and they do handle their pricing very well, and they're just and you know what, they have a right to do what they got to do. I think they've earned the right, but you know what, I guarantee you this: EA went up to them and pushed them. They went up to Disney and pushed them to have them do a license. They didn't. They weren't asked. I don't believe they were asked. I believe that they pushed their way through it. I can't prove that, but I really fully think that. And
Billy.
Yeah.
I won't be surprised that after they release that Star Wars game, I don't know how it'll end up. If I release a DLC and then slap the freaking first tag on it, and then release another DLC and then slap another first tag.
Hey guys, we got a new
DLC.
Hey guys.
And then push a disc for all free DLC to GameStop and tell you, okay, right, $24.99. Okay,
yeah.
Sure. No.
Hey guys, we got a new lightsaber color. Only $5.99.
That's how they do it.
Yeah. I would pay
Let me tell you, all free DLCs now, some of them out for New Speed, they had a card pack for the first one. They had another, like, five cards for another pack, and then they got another six cards in the dirt pack. Plus the expansion for the airport,
yeah.
And they want
$24.99
for it.
Well, you know, what are you? You know, it's just the end of the day. What are you gonna do? That's just, it's just business.
Yeah, it's just business.
I can't. It's like there's nothing I can do about it. There's nothing anyone can do about it. It's just a bit. It's just business. we'll see where it goes, but that's not really the point. Like, this is really, we just wanted to do this because we wanted to say a farewell to LucasArts. It's always a shame when a company it's always a shame when a company goes down.
Yep.
Especially ones we liked. Like, if they like if LucasArts always did a bad job, didn't care, and they were just complete dicks, I would not care. We would be doing a celebration.
No, but this is a cornerstone right now. This is a
close to LucasArts.
Yeah. And,
if EA goes down, I would care. Assholes.
Yeah, and you know, Star Wars plays such a big role in a lot of people's lives, especially the games, because that was the way you can interact with the world. You know, that's how it is with video games. That's why usually directors like having video games for their movies. They want people to interact with it as much as possible. Well, the directors that care.
Yeah.
And you know what? That's why Steven Spielberg wanted the E.T. game up so bad. But look how that turned out when they rushed it out.
Yeah, I know.
That was funny.
You can't. Well, listen. Some things are made to be games. Some things aren't. You know, you gotta live well enough alone.
But Star Wars, come on, such.
Oh no!
You have to make a game for Star Wars.
Yeah, you gotta. Yeah, I'm not gonna argue that.
Yeah, that's so much fun stuff.
Yeah.
Aren't you a little short to be a stormtrooper?
Well, stay here and write, you stuck up bitch.
Yeah, really.
You know, if you actually realize where the stormtroopers came from, it's actually like not that's actually a legitimate question if you know where the stormtroopers actually came from, if you know what I mean.
Well, where did they come from?
You don't know where the idea of the stormtroopers came from?
Well, the idea? Not really.
Do you know what the stormtroopers were?
What?
The SA?
The SA?
Hitler's bodyguards?
Oh, right.
And
there's a lot of World War II influence in.
Yeah, like, you know what Vader is?
What?
Vader is the modification of the word Vater, which means father. Ah. Dark father.
Oh, that's clever.
That makes sense now.
That's interesting.
The evil father.
Ah.
Yeah.
And, yep.
That's a mind bump right there.
Yeah. Well, that's where the stormtroopers came from, because Hitler's SA was called the stormtroopers. So, and it's like, and when he turned it into the SS, you had to be like above a certain height. You had to be 6 feet tall or above. And everyone knows Mark Hamill is a runt. So, it's like, aren't you a little short to be a stormtrooper? It's like, the uniform. Duh.
Oh, that's great.
Did you not forget that you were undercover, Mister?
You know, and if you can recreate that kind of stuff very well, you'll have a fun game.
Yeah, that's kind of like Space World War II right there.
Yeah.
It's like Star Wars.
You just can't get more brilliant than that. It's just a phenomenon that's like a cornerstone of the world's history.
Yeah, it is. It is. Everybody from the 70s onward knows what Star Wars is.
Yeah, really.
And you know what? It was an influential series, and hell, I loved Star Wars when I was a kid.
Yeah, me too.
I loved it. I was nuts about it. I was crazy about it. Episode 4 was my favorite. I don't care what anybody
says.
Yeah,
episode 4 was so great. When that blows everyone's minds, no matter when you see it or how long it's been.
Listen, I will always love when I say the first three, I mean the original 4 through 6. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I remember talking to, you know what, like a lot of people get passionate about it, especially, and gaming's no different. People get passionate.
You know what's really weird? George Lucas did the episodes 4, 5, and 6 with minimal technology,
yeah.
And they still had better effects than.
Well,
they still had better effects than the episode 1.
That's another subject for another day, but we're out of time. So, thank you guys as always for joining us. We'll see you next week.
All right, Triple M reporting out.
You want a piece of candy? JL Dragon 90, I'm out.
Yeah. All right. Want to say goodbye, Rosemary?
Bye.
Oh, she said bye.
Shut up.
She said bye, Billy.
Yeah.
Bye-bye. No,
this is good padding for the rest of the episode.
Shut up.
All right, goodbye, everyone.
Bye.